Hi, I'm Steve Ostrom.
And I'm Keith Ford. And we're here at Rock Island Auction Company today bringing you some more guns from the vault. Steve, what do we have here?
Today we've got a Colt 357 Magnum.
Okay, but which 357 Magnum do we have?
It's the 357 Magnum. That's the model.
Oh, okay.
This is an I-frame 357 Magnum, and that's all Colt called it, the model 357 Magnum. And for you Colt guys, if you look at it from back here, it looks an awful lot like a Python. In fact, it is. It's an I-frame gun, same internal lock work, but it's made in a plain barrel version with not quite as high a finish and a matte top. And this was a working man's 357 in the day, back when Colt was cranking these things out. This was a less expensive alternative to the Python. Now these things are up there pretty close to Python prices because of their scarcity. You ever handled one of these before?
I have not. I've seen them, but I've never had one in hand before.
There's, other than the barrel and the finish, there's nothing special about it. I mean, the Python had more care put into it, mm-hmm. but the inner workings, it feels like a Python. And for a while, it was a thing to actually convert those into Pythons by adding a barrel. To do that, though, you have to weld up this portion here because the Python has that rib,
mm-hmm.
and it's got to meet up to a bigger boss on the front of the frame. So you could weld one of those up, and that was a real thing for a while. They did that.
Now, there was a guy that did a lot of conversions on these.
Yep, George Nani did that, the guy that wrote Pistol Smithing.
Yeah.
And you could have yourself a first-class gun that way because Python barrels weren't particularly expensive back then, and these guns were relatively inexpensive compared to a Python, so it made a lot of financial sense to do that. And a lot of those guns got converted over, just like a lot of Smith & Wessons had Python barrels put on them mm-hmm. to make Smythons.
Yeah, I've seen a lot of those.
Now all this stuff costs too much to really go cutting on.
Yeah, you don't want to do that, but yeah. Matted rip, matted top right here, matted along the back.
Right. The grips are, you know, kind of a matte finish.
Mm-hmm.
They're not fitted up like Python
no.
grips normally are. So this was a kind of a working man's gun here, basically.
Yeah.
It's a big frame 357, would take heavy loads all day, had all the features as far as adjustable sights and nice trigger and everything as a Python, but just wasn't as pretty.
Yeah. Sweet.
So if you ever get a deal on one of these, I mean, don't pass it up, because it is basically a Python in disguise. Nice gun, hard to come by, and the value on these just keeps going up. And we'd like to thank Rock Island for letting us look at this and all the other guns here today. So tune in next time when we bring you another gun from the vault.